I felt so grateful to the curators for making it seem like I was an organized person. I mean, I didn't even know I had half of this stuff. They went through all my drawers and boxes and they found all this stuff. And I felt in very good hands. And obviously, when I came here, the Cinematheque is such an amazing place and such a beautiful place. And this is almost my favorite because it makes it inviting, and I think the best compliment I've gotten is from kids who don't usually go to museums and thought, well, it makes it more accessible and somewhat more like a carnival sideshow than any kind of art show. So it was something that I felt very, very comfortable with, and again, I thank all of you for making it such a beautiful presentation. As you can tell, I don't speak very well, and it was something that for me was always my form of communication. It was a way for me to explore my subconscious, get ideas out without really speaking. And it wasn't until that I had became a director where I had to learn how to start speaking to people. But for me, drawings were always a way to. I felt most comfortable in terms of exploring ideas and things. Ideas always felt more comfortable coming more from the subconscious than they did sort of from an intellectual point of view. So that's always been important for me. Like, for instance, I would never think about things. I would never say, I'm going to draw this. Oftentimes, the drawing just comes. That's where the character from Nightmare Before Christmas came, just drawings. And then after drawing it several times, that's when you start to think about it. And so for me, it's never an intellectual idea. It was always more of an emotional idea, which is something I felt much more comfortable in terms of it feeling more personal rather than, because sometimes the intellectual mind plays tricks on itself. And for me, something just...